So occasionally I'll get messages from people asking me, can I do a tutorial about my earmuffs, which I think is ridiculous because they're just earmuffs. I've stuck bits onto them myself. This was just stuck. I'll get into it in the video. But the reason I'm doing it now is because these things, I've had these for so long, and this thing just keeps coming on and off. I've actually put a little screw in here to try and widen out that little plastic thing that keeps this thing in here, but it just keeps popping off and it's really annoying. So that's what I'm going to do in this video. We're going to be making a new pair of these guys. But first, introducing Raid Shadow Legends, a turn-based RPG done right. I know you've been hearing about Raid everywhere, but there's a good reason for that. Raid is one of the top 3 ranked RPGs in the Google Play Store, and has just been nominated for the Google Play's Best of 2019 Player's Choice Award. The game is crazy popular, with almost 15 million downloads in the last 6 months. What is Raid? Raid's an epic dark fantasy, a hero collection, turn-based game with over 400 champions for you to collect and personally customize. Enjoy a fully voiced story campaign. Raid with friends in a clan. Gather elves, orcs, undead, knights, and more. And the best part, it's totally free to play. Some other cool features in the game. Multi-battle auto mode. Set battles to run automatically while you go do something else. Spend less time grinding and more time developing your teams and fighting the fun stuff. Weekly tournaments and events, fighting in the arena, running special dungeons, are just leveling up your hero. There's always ways each week to compete and win extra prizes. The game is growing super fast. Check out this cool roadmap they've published. They actually have huge plans for updates in the game for over 6 months. So there's infinite content for you to enjoy and no opportunity to get bored. A new faction, a new tag team arena feature, and even a new clan boss you'll be able to fight with your clan mates. So what are you waiting for? Go to the video description, click the special links, and you'll get 50,000 silver and a free epic champion to start your journey. Good luck! Okay, so this guy here, we're going to start by taking apart the existing ones. Got a lot of random bits I stuck onto it. What is this thing? Some sort of brass wheel or dial. Can I find a second one of these somewhere? Probably not, but we'll find something close. Is there anything else that was Philip's head? These are Philip's head. This is the little brass thing that holds on the little iPod shuffle I let use, which marks me out as an incredibly old person now. They don't even make them anymore. On the occasions when I've needed them, I've had to buy them secondhand. A more modern person might have a phone in their pocket and then use the Bluetooth, a pair of Bluetooth thingies to transmit the things into their face. One of these guys. I like it because it has very little moving parts. I'm way more likely to lose them than for them to break, which is an advantage they have over phones and stuff. Whoops! Where did that go? So my initial idea with this guy was that sometimes when I feel the pressure building up inside my head, like when I'm getting frustrated, I always take these guys off first. Like a physical pressure is building up inside my head. And also, I tried to change it into a clock at some point. I said, oh, it'd be cool, I'll rip that pin out and have like a clock. But I bought a cheap wristwatch and did an experiment, and the sound of the ticking, I just held it up to my ear for less than 10 seconds and went, nope, I can't have that ticking in my ear all day long. So then I never did it. So these guys, clock. These were recycled from a pair of earphones. Back of this thing is all rusted. I guess it's just a lump of steel and it doesn't matter, but still.
the box the new earmuffs came in. I can put these speakers in there because I don't want a little piece of speakers hanging around in a metalwork workshop. If the magnets, I swept off this before I started. Ooh, there's a piece of tape here. Headphones get too much metal in them. Like, these are big speakers, so they can take a lot. I've had, I don't know how many phones, older fashion phones I've destroyed by having them in a welding shop. This piece of foam out. Get this piece of foam out. These lugs, which are my main technological contribution, allow me to wear my welding helmet on top of my earmuffs. That I don't have to, like, I don't, my welding helmet doesn't have a head thing inside. Bet you didn't think a pair of earmuffs would have this many parts. Holy moly. Put these in here till I need them. And this is the new pair of earmuffs. The very first thing we're going to do is very carefully peel back this guy. It's a good thing I bought spare ones. There we go. Now, is the inner stuff damaged? It is. So this one is actually junk, but now I figured out how to take it off properly. Ta-da! Now, where's the junked pair? Figure out what I have to do to get the reason I cut out this way, this made it so that I could slide that speaker in. How did this go again? Was this just the size of this? Yeah, I guess it was. So what I'm gonna do is close to the edge. Did I have to make this thing taller too? This brass part and this brass part are from the original one. I've been trying to find stuff to replace it. So I went because I needed to get new little screws anyway. Ah, here we go. A bag of various brass bits and bobs from the hardware store, just to see, can I get something that looks like this and something that looks similar to this. That looks pretty freaking close. So yeah, I think that is close to that. And this guy here, this thing here is close to it. So I think that will work. So this was actually a really high-end regulator, but it's critically broke in some unfixable way. And the reason I want to use this is because a lot of more modern regulators. This is another broken one. The cover on the glass on the outside is plastic. I can't get that one off. But this one, because it, and the cover and the lens on the front is all one piece. But the cover on this guy is brass. And look, that's a big thick piece of cut glass in behind the cover. Crazy. So I want to use this one for a silly side of respirator gauge. Is there a way to get this needle off without breaking it? Oh, off it came. I have the bits I want. Although, even though the glass is cool, I might actually replace that with a plastic one because that is actually heavy and might contribute to you going, this pair of earmuffs is too heavy. And because this is brass, it means you can polish it up. I wonder, is it made of bronze as opposed to brass? Because while it's shined up, it's not as shiny as brass components get. I guess it's about the same. So these are the lenses I use in my goggles. I have loads of them, but unfortunately they're all just a little bit too small for this thing. Like, that one didn't go through, but sit right. Like, I don't want to make a thing where it's like looks like it's sticking out or whatever. So I traced around the outside of one of these. Oh no, actually it was the glass piece. And now I'm gonna make one that's just a little bit bigger. Okay, finally. So the reason I did that is I wanted this in here. Sand this a bit. And then when I get this guy in here, it'll be a better, snugger fit. So the normal one comes with this like overhead strap, the crown strap. That's, you know, a little plastic thing, but I don't want to use that. I want to use a leather one. So these little clips for the plastic one have to go. This is a steel rod. Why did it have flux on it? Okay, I need to make two of these guys and one of these guys. Starting off with pieces the same length is kind of important just for figuring out what size to make the things. I think that broke a thing off it. Ah, screw it, brass is cheap, I'll make another one. God damn it! So a thing I've never noticed before. I tried bending the things and it kept snapping. And there's a whole bunch of people that were like saying, duh, that always happens when you bend the little brass rod without annealing it first. And it's like, well, I didn't anneal either of these guys. And these guys have been on my head for decades without, not decades, a decade maybe. Without snapping. So I don't know. So to anneal the brass, according to the interwebs, we heat it up red hot and then we quench it. Through experimentation, it was revealed that that was also wrong. The brass kept snapping after doing that. The correct answer turned out to be just heating up the brass until it started to change color a little bit. Like just started to go not shiny and then letting it air cool. Which just goes to show any piece of advice you find on the internet will just be some random guy saying something for no reason. You should only trust anything you see with video at the very least. Okay, now I want to see where the lugs go, because arguably they're the only structurally important thing. Now there's two holes here. I think what happened was, oh, I couldn't, I had to raise it. Okay, now I vaguely remember. There's two holes here, there should only be one. I don't have a second one to locate that hole with. Try to figure out what's a fixed position. Okay, and that gives us a weird Z. But I think using the weird Z, it'll be enough to make sure that the two lugs are in the same place on both sides. I need to shorten these a little guy a bit. How thick is this? I'll stick a washer in between the two. Okay, holy moly, there we go. Okay, so that's all the structural stuff on here. Which should I get in first? Probably the decorations on first. And then refitting all of the speaker parts. Put the speakers this way. The thing was on this side. So, on the other one, this thing was up here, but, I don't know, man, I think it would look better there, because there's just not a lot of space going on. Where's the other one, the original? Here. Did that thing even fit in there? Okay, is that all the hardware on, or is there more? That might be it. This is the leather strap that runs across the crown. It's called the crown strap in the actual diagram for the original. Oh boy, and this piece I found is just long enough to do it. How wide is it? It's about half an inch wide. Wonder if I go here. Here. Can I just drag the ruler? This one doesn't even look like it was cut square. It's hard to believe that this is how stiff the original one was when it was new. Will that even go through the things, I wonder? Ah, yeah, it will. Ooh, the bend might be tricky though. I'd have to squeeze it with the pliers to encourage it to take that sharp bend. Can I make a second new strap? Or is this too short now? I was initially thinking about replacing the lock nuts and bolts I used originally with leather rivets, but then I realized that the lock nut arrangement is actually better, because if you decide that you need a new leather strap or have to change the size of it or whatever, it's much easier to undo. It's less destructive than if you have to undo a genuine leather rivet, which can only be undone by smashing it and probably damaging the leather. So, kind of the inciting incident for this whole video is I found these guys, which is a set of the exact same type of speaker as I use, and the only difference was that the it was thrown out, it was garbaged, because one half of it was broken, and I, having small kids, have had to repair loads of sets of headphones. So I am quite confident that I will be able to do this. Where's the matches? Soldering headphones back on. One of the things, many things to be careful of, is you gotta burn off the very tip of the wire, because it has a protective layer on it. Which one's that second lump it's going to? Can I get that to stay put? Now that those are like just barely holding on, let's see, can I add just a little tiny droplet on top? Now to see, did that actually work? And if you think this is bad, I had to Rickroll myself 5 or 6 times getting that track on here. Now, for the last steps. Coaxing it in. There we go. Quick check that everything's still working. Okay, both still working. Make that these things aren't tangled around anything. And now to reapply these guys. I'm using gasket cement. We need to use a lot of it because the thing is still sticky and the gasket cement is fierce powerful. The usual mistake I make is using too much. Whoa! Goddamn compressor scared the shite on me. It's gone too late. Oh, the blaze is crawling with rats. The people won't be far behind. You know, before I just used a wire tie. But I wonder, is there a way I could secure that guy there? I have these guys in my pocket. Just black wire ties. I find they're best for keeping the wire tidy. Because they're somewhat stiff. But unlike full wire, they don't snag on your hair. If you have hair. And if you get into making anything more fixed or solid, you get into the territory where it might damage the hair or you. There we go. So those guys are secured on there. Like that. It's actually good having like slack for when these guys twist around. And like that it can, you know, that it wouldn't, if you fixed it, like if you did a hard, like if this hole came out here, I'd worry that if this thing twisted, it would put too much stress on the wire. So that's why I have this big loop of it like this. So now the only thing I have to do is to tidy the wire up. When I was making them initially, I kind of toyed with the idea of making it so that this didn't have this extra bit. But this way, now you can, if you want to, unroll them and in a pinch use them as like your computer headphones or whatever. I feel like I had that wrapped around on the other pair. I didn't have it that way. I feel like I had it this way. Oh man, that's laborious. But wrapped around this way. Certainly looks tidier. So, if you put the breather actually on, you weld it how it stays where it's supposed to be, because it's not rubbing off the front of it. And I imagine the same would happen if you had a normal respirator too. So, and then you can Ah. go.
So, as per usual, when I make it a small thing like these guys, why make one of a thing when you can make two of a thing?
And also, as per usual, when I make two of a relatively small item, the second one is up for charity auction. Now, which one is the second one will be up to whoever wins the auction. This one is made with all the new parts, and I think the sound out of it is slightly better than the older one, which is just rebuilt using all the original parts. So if you would like to make the world a little bit less awful and buy a bizarre artisanal pair of steampunk earmuff things, I'll even throw in my older iPod, the black one, because it no longer lasts a full 8-hour day. You can sample whatever weird music I have on it too. I can't remember. I might go through to delete some of the more embarrassing stuff. Yep, the auction will go for 10 days. There'll be details in the video description. Send us an email if you would like to place a bid on a pair of weirdo earmuffs.